Well, we've got a lot of players seeing their first NBA action. Richard, do you remember your rookie debut?
100%. Do you want to know why, Ryan?
Please do tell.
Because I still have the box score to my rookie debut. And
Substitution here for Utah. Gaze checked in for Olynyk. Horton Tucker comes in for Vanderbilt. Beasley's checked in for Clarkson. And Sexton subbed in for Conley. So on the floor for Utah, Malik Beasley is out there with Colin Sexton. Then there's Talen Horton Tucker. Then there's Rudy Gay. And it's Markkanen in at the power forward position.
Yeah, just hasn't been able to find his rhythm offensively. And that's having a ripple effect.
They get it again. Wiseman. And it's Wiseman with the jam.
Boy, I like their energy coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Couldn't come up with a much better start than this. They just have to keep it going.
Beasley outside. Pass to Markkanen. Lays it up and banks it in. Markkanen's got eight.
Pounding it inside early and often, setting a physical tone.
Here's Baddest one. It's guarded by Markkanen. Here's Baddest one. Utah with the rebound.
Just enough resistance to force the miss. Barely. That's one he'll generally make.
The former home of the Warriors, Richard, Oakland. What was it like to play over in the East Bay?
Listen, it was a lot more fun when I was playing in a Warriors uniform versus playing against them. Those crowds are insane. Maybe the loudest in the NBA, although the Boston fans might have a little bit of something to say about that. But I must say, this new building is gorgeous.
And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for the Warriors. There's a minute 12 left to play in the first quarter. Pass to Horton Tucker. Now Beasley. Here's Horton Tucker. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change.
A bit undersized, his hops make him a legit small ball four.
And stolen by Markkanen. 44 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Curry with it. Beasley covers. Pass to Baddest one. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
I don't mind that. I mean, they met him at the rim and temporarily prevented the points.
For the Warriors, number 10, taking two shots.
And he makes a first. Draymond Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. And that's good as he hits both shots.
For a star like him, you get lots of opportunities at the line, and he's great at cashing them in.
Here's Baddest one. And so far in this one, 2 for 4.
And the defense has no one to blame but themselves. I mean, they just let him get right to the rim.
That's a great possession. Put your best players in a position to succeed.
Outside Sexton. Pass to Markkanen. Banked it in off the glass. Markkanen's got 13 now.
When guys are moving the ball, sharing it, it makes the game so much more fun, both as a player and as a fan.
Baddest one with the bucket.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Always plays hard until the final whistle, no matter what the situation is.
Stephen Curry getting it done for the Golden State Warriors. Hitting three trays in the quarter, providing some sharp shooting. We'll be right back. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. Boy, for the Warriors, this has been the game they've wanted to have.
But what I love is the tremendous belief in their bench. They were looking for points, and their reserves delivered.
Sometimes you just need a change of pace. The bench delivered that.
Curry and Thompson pair up at the one and the two. Then it's Green, then it's Kuminga, and it's Baddest one in at the power forward position. So that's the group out there for Golden State. Conley with the ball. Green picks him up. Thompson outside. Three-pointer off the mark.
he didn't make them pay for that weak defense, but they just can't rely on him to miss those kind of shots.
So much to say about Draymond's game. Tough to say anyone else in the league has a larger impact on their team on both sides of the floor.
And what an aggressive move to the rim. He's really trying to fire up his teammates right now.
Boy, it's not hard to feel inspired after a teammate makes that kind of finish.
And that could be the spark they needed to make a little run as they try to even this thing up.
And Richard, the weight that Draymond carries for this team can't be forgotten.
The impact he has on the defense alone is remarkable. But then you factor in the offensive ability, bringing the ball up the floor. There is no doubt he is the vocal leader and the heartbeat.
RJ, you played with some of the greats. LeBron, Duncan, Dirk, Jason Kidd, just to name a few. But if the game were on the line, who would you want taking the last shot, putting you on the spot here?
I'm going to be really honest. I have been in great situations with all of those guys, and they have all delivered. So this isn't, but I'm going to go with the person that's delivered the biggest shot of my career, and that was Kyrie Irving, and he hit the clutchest shot in NBA history. Argue with me if you want. You're going to lose it.
No argument here. And it's good. 2 points. He's got 15.
And he's coming off a huge performance, and his confidence couldn't be any higher. And his coach knows that, too.
When it ain't broke, leave it alone. Until someone stops him, just let him roll.
Pass to Markkanen. Three-pointer. That's his sixth make in 11 tries.
And they seem to have found a nice groove here in the second period.
Golden State has gone 5 of 10 from beyond the three-point line in this game. Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played so far. Baddest one with the bucket.
That's how you up the ante. Come right back at
them. Yeah, I love the competitive fire right there. You drain a triple on us, and I'm coming for my revenge.
To the inside. And Vanderbilt gets it to go on the assist by Conley. Conley's got 4 assists in the game. Takes a 3. Clarkson grabs a miss. For Utah, they've gotten off to a perfect 4-for-4 start of the second. Pass to Conley. Now here's Olynyk. And here's Clarkson. Puts up a 3. No good there. Here's Baddest one. Guarded by Vanderbilt. Baddest one with the bucket.
We see this every night. He has the skill and versatility to keep a defense guessing.
Utah's gone 1-of-2 from deep in the second quarter. And he jams it home with authority.
Adding insult to injury with the dunk off the steal.
Nice to see a good play on D. That led to some fireworks.
Once he poked it away, you knew what was on his mind.
Markkanen outside. And now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter here. Outside Olynyk. Pass to Clarkson. Stolen by Thompson. Here's Baddest one. And that one's good. Thompson's got his 3rd basket on the night right there.
Yeah, their defense is starting to wear down. That's 3 straight buckets at the rim.
Clarkson outside. Markkanen against Curry. Outside Conley. Fires the 3. Offensive board. Vanderbilt. It's stolen by Curry. And the Warriors pushing it up now. Here's Baddest one. Got a hand on it. 1:16 left to play in the first half. Conley finds Vanderbilt. Now Markkanen. And Markkanen with the stuff.
Oh, nice feed. On time and on target.
Going inside. And it goes. That makes him 9-for-13 now.
He is getting everything he wants. The defense is seemingly powerless to slow him down. It's sad.
Conley against Curry. Here's Vanderbilt. And Markkanen with the stuff.
Grabs the board and goes right in for the putback. I love it, B.A.
Yeah, wanted to close the gap. Makes sense to get aggressive on the glass here. Here's Baddest One. Oh, you can tell he's feeling it now. 10 of 14 from the field.
Man, that's now 10 straight points in the paint. I'm not sure what's happened to their defense.
Down low. And so the ball's out of bounds. Olynyk tucks it last. And you got to be in awe of incredible defensive efforts like this.
Let's see if that block can amp up this team. I mean, they're looking for anything to get themselves going.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Wiggins, he's checked in for Kuminga. And it's Poole in for Stephen Curry. Colin Sexton's checked in for Utah. The Warriors have gone 8 of 11 in the second quarter. Pass to Baddest One. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
Third personal foul.
Jared Vanderbilt picks one up.
No debate there. He got hammered. Yeah, just knocking down every free throw. I mean, I love to see this kind of efficiency.
Green's checked in for the Warriors. Vanderbilt with it. Olynyk in the post. That shot missing. Pass to Baddest One. 4 seconds left. And he bangs it home with one hand.
And making the extra pass. Wiggins' teammates appreciate his willingness to get it to them when they're uncovered.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors. They're feeling great. A 21-point lead. It hasn't taken them too many shots to get their points. They're winning with efficiency. We'll be back in a moment. And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the rout that it's threatening to be. Golden State has gone 6 for 12 from deep so far in this game. Kicking off the second half, here's Will Hardy's five. We've got Mike Conley. Kelly Olynyk is out there with Jared Vanderbilt. Then it's Jordan Clarkson, and it's Markkanen in at the three. Out of bounds, it'll be Utah's ball.
Entering the NBA can be a difficult challenge, and age can add to that challenge. Jonathan Kuminga was just 19 years old when he stepped onto an NBA court.
Conley passes to Markkanen. Back to Conley. Pass to Clarkson. And it's out of bounds. Still Utah's ball.
Great read to get a hand in there and disrupt the play.
Yeah, I think he was hoping to maybe even get the steal, but I agree. He still got a good outcome.
Five on the clock. The kick to Olynyk. Fires for three. He shot that time, not on target. And it's the Warriors taking it the other way. Boy, being so young for his draft class, Kuminga has done well in the league, Richard.
What I like is how he's capitalized on his minutes. Any chance he gets to shine, he works hard to make the most of it. That's the kind of dedication that is invaluable in a young guy.
And for the Jazz, they're shooting around 44%. Not bad. Curry against Conley. Pass to Markkanen. Now here's Olynyk. The shot no good.
Defense pulled out all the stops to shut him down there.
Here's Baddest One, guarded by Olynyk.
They've been very well-rounded and extremely focused.
Yeah, not just an impressive showing on offense, but on defense as well, executing their game plan perfectly.
Who poked away? They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Thompson with it, and Clarkson picks him up defensively. On the break! Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
With all the attention Clay gets, it can lead to open looks for others. Nice decision.
Conley passes to Markkanen. Back to Conley. For three. And another miss by Utah.
Coming out stone cold here. Sometimes the break will do that to you.
Well, Richard, as a former player yourself, what's your take on stars demanding trades and jumping around the league so much?
It's tough because I've seen the other thing happen to stars. Blake Griffin re-signs with the Clippers. They show him videos of putting his jersey in the rafters, and then he's traded a year later. So I think everybody has to figure out what is best for them, but you also have to try as an individual and as a professional to fulfill your obligations. And I think trades can be someplace in the middle of that.
Off the inbound pass, and Markkanen gets it to go on the assist by Vanderbilt. Markkanen's got 22 points. Second half of play here with just under 2.5 minutes passed. On the wing, Thompson. Pass to Battisone. And that one is hammered home!
Doing more work in the painted area. He has really excelled inside.
All right, let's get a report from Allie.
Thanks, guys. The NBA last season celebrated its 75th anniversary and announced the 75 greatest players in NBA history, gathering the living greats during the All-Star break. A lot of history, but Commissioner Silver said, we're a pretty young league when you think about it. Brian, I guess it's all relative.
Yeah, indeed. Thanks for that, Allie. Baddest one, no good. For Utah, they've gone 2 of 5 in this third quarter. To the paint. Here's Clarkson. Thompson with some nice D. The Warriors have gotten 4 of their first 5 shots to go since the break. Here's Battisone. And foul call. Almost got it to go in, but he'll go to the line for 2. Jared Vanderbilt picks one up. Draymond Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. Poole comes in for Stephen Curry. Utah has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. Beasley outside. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Clarkson for 3. The Warriors pull it in.
They're losing because he is struggling so bad, and he has not looked comfortable all game. When we talk about guys who broke out during the 2021-22 season, Jordan Poole might be at the top of that list, going from a nice rotation player to a legit NBA scorer.
Talking about Jordan Poole, his confidence never wavered, Richard.
No, remember, Poole shot 33% his rookie season. Lots of people kind of wrote him off, but Jordan's always believed in his game, took advantage of the injuries to Clay and Steph, grabbing those extra shots.
And really strong at the line since the break.
The Jazz shooting a low 29% since halftime. Here's Gay. Oh, it's Gay with the jam.
He finds a shooter in motion and is confident he can thread him with the lead pass. Well done.
Here's Battisone. Good. He's got 44.
Leading scorer on the night, and he looks very hungry for more. Keep feeding him. Operation Feed the Horse.
Sexton passes to Vanderbilt. And it's out of bounds. Still Utah's ball.
Jazz ball.
Clarkson passes to Vanderbilt. Ooh, good finish at the rack off the slick feed. Vanderbilt's got 6.
Big ups to this coaching staff. Great play design there.
Here's Battisone, guarded by Vanderbilt. Battisone with the bucket.
Taking it right at the rack. I mean, that defense is looking real frustrated.
That's the kind of aggression you want to see when you've got a team on the ropes.
That was another look at our Mobile One drive of the game just a moment ago.
And this is exactly what you love to see. Up big, not letting up. Keep on applying pressure to their defense.
Horton Tucker, he's checked in for Utah. And we've got 28 seconds left in the third quarter. Offensive rebound. Here's Vanderbilt. Another shot. And they get it back. Fade away. And Vanderbilt slams it in.
And their offensive rebounding is such a strength for them when he's on the floor.
Yeah, he really...
Oh my goodness! How about that? He's a living highlight reel.
Seriously, that could end up being one of the best dunks of the year.
Warriors foul. Number 10. Second personal foul. First team foul.
Beasley for three. He can't hit that time. And so it's the Golden State Warriors in total control. Up by 29 going into the break. Defense is setting the tone. Back to the game after this break. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Now, I know he's a big man, but he's got some point guard in him if he's making passes like this.
And for the defense, it's so tough to guard a big man with that kind of court vision and dime-dropping ability.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same for the first three quarters. We've got Green, Dante DiVincenzo out there with Jordan Poole. Then it's Andre Iguodala. And it's Baddest One in at the five, roaming the paint. That's the Warriors five. He's all alone. Another one goes. Incredible.
My goodness. 50 for the game.
Just putting on a show. Well, the grimace of pain tells it all. He's hurt. Let's hope he's okay.
And by the look of it, guys, this could be serious.
Look, I'm no doctor, and I know that might be a surprise to a lot of you people, but look, that looked pretty harsh, and he's certainly going to have to miss some extended time.
All right, the Jazz making a change here. And the NBA last season introducing a 100-camera system that allows for a video game-like presentation with virtual angles. It's pretty cool. Video games used to chase the league. Now the league's kind of chasing the video games.
Yeah, well, this is where the future is heading. It is so cool to see all the different angles that you can now see a basketball game from. That's what makes it fun. That's what makes it exciting. And the NBA, they're doing the right thing.
And I know scouting departments are using them as evaluation tools as well.
Oh, they're always going to figure out a way to scout more and to evaluate more because it helps them when they're negotiating players' contracts.
Inside, here's Azubuike, and he goes in for the dunk. A few possessions into the fourth, just over a minute played. Here's Baddest One, and good! There's another!
That's 52 points for him.
Making it all look too easy right now. And no lack of aggression on that move. Good for the 2K drive.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close. They'll take possessions like that one all day. And that's what happens when you don't take care of the ball.
Hey, that makes the turnover hurt even more.
We know mistakes lead to breaks. That's just textbook right there.
Back to Alexander Walker. Here's Gay. That's tipped.
And the shooter had very little space on that attempt.
I'm sure they'll think twice about shooting against him next time.
Baddest One with the bucket.
Absolutely ruthless. He's not about to start showing mercy now.
This is what you expect from him, just coming alive and dominating in effortless fashion here in the fourth.
Deflected! And he recovers it. Pass to Gay. Oh, it's Gay with the jam.
A quality pass, setting up a quality shot. It's just textbook basketball.
Here's Baddest One. A quick shot there. It's off target.
Not that time, but that's a shot that he's going to make more oftentimes than not.
Here's Abaji. Parries the corner three.
We talk about the importance of shooting while in rhythm. He feels confident doing this from downtown on the break.
Here's Baddest One. The rebound by the Jazz. Gay's got his fifth rebound in this one. Pass to Horton Tucker. If you're just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Dunks it hard with one hand. Wow, he makes it look easy.
Now that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
Yeah, you like the pick to set up the open shot. But it leads to a dunk. Okay, even better. He'll take it.
And he's going for the lob. Hammers the lob through.
Oh, great teamwork right there.
Hey, you got to love the finish. Bringing it down with some attitude. There's a minute 47 left to play in the fourth. Here's Baddest One. Oh, and just miss after miss right now. The Jazz have gotten 5 shots out of 9 to go in this fourth. Here's Gay. That one falls. Gay's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Nice ball movement there. That's how you break down the defense.
Here's Battist one. And he banks in the layup.
Well, the scoreboard tells you everything you need to know about this one. A great showing here for the Warriors.
Pretty clear who the better team was today. They dominated in just about every phase of this game, Grant.
B.A., it's almost hard to think what didn't go well for them. Their plan, their execution, everything was absolutely on point.
And reaching a nice milestone, an even 20 wins on the year.
Always good to start a season series off with a W. They show tonight they take this team seriously, and the next 2 matchups between these two should be fun.
And as it was happening, as it was building, you knew this was a monster game for the baddest one.
He did a great job following his team's game plan and not rushing anything on offense, which allowed him to catch fire.
Golden State has gotten 6 of 13 shots to go from outside the arc. Parked it down low that time. Got hit with the 3-second call.
Jazz ball.
There's 45 seconds left in the final quarter. Pass to Alexander Walker. Iguodala with the rebound.
Showing great intensity around the rim is part of why he's a respected defender.
Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how to defend at the rim.
I love great defense. Just quick to establish his feet, and he takes the hit.
It's great to see a fantastic block on replay once again.
What a play. I mean, that'll have the offense thinking twice about taking shots in his presence.
2-second difference between shot and game clock. Here's Agbaji. From deep. And they'll get another chance.
That's been the difference tonight. They've been insanely disruptive on the glass.
On the wing, Alexander Walker. And so Golden State takes this one, and by a big margin. Boy, they were something special to watch tonight, and the crowd loving every second of it.
It's always a great feeling when you play this well for your fans. This team really showed what it's capable of.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching. We'll see you later.
Na ang ating sundo pagkagaling sa eskwela rekta palit kami seta tako sa pag